Hi, I'm Mr. Vaz, SAP Basis Trainer. Today I'm going to show you how to install SAP BW. To install SAP BW, we have to prepare operating system with all prerequisites. Just this is Windows Server operating system. Windows Server Enterprise, and the RAM assigned here is 8 GB and 64-bit operating system. And just let me show you the computer name. The computer name provided here is BWINST, and the DNS primary suffix I have assigned is ITL.NET, and the full computer name is bwinst.itl.net. For any SAP installation, you have to do this step. It is mandate. So once it is done, next you have to check the performance options, that is virtual memory settings, and you select this adjust for best performance so that it will work perfectly and it will utilize the resources for performance, not for appearance. Click on advanced. Here total paging file size for all drives, that is 25,000 MB, that means 25 GB I have allocated. So SAP recommends 20 GB for virtual memory. Just I have allocated 25 GB as initial size and 30 GB as maximum size. You have to do this second step, and then you have to install Java J2 SDK. It is already installed. Okay, this is the J2 SDK, and you have to set the path to the J2 SDK. From the computer, right click properties and go to advanced system settings and go to environment variables. Here I have created Java home, that is java_home C:/J2SDK1.4.2_22-X64. And the path also have set here. Just P and click on the edit, and this is first C:/Oracle. The path is not yet set. Yes, if it is not set, you can set it. So it is here. Just copy this and put this front. Okay, so that this version will take as priority C:/J2SDK 1.4.2.2_22-X64. Click OK. And now test the Java whether it is working or not. Just go to run and type cmd. Java is the command and it is executing, and Java C, it is also executing, and Java hyphen version. So Java version also showing J2 SDK 1.4.2_22. So once the Java is tested, you can proceed with the Oracle installation. In this server, I have already installed Oracle. Just I will show you where it is installed. Go to computer and double click on C drive. There is a Oracle folder. Here, this is the dev folder. This is the Oracle home. Okay, and you can also check from command prompt sql \nolog. So this is the Oracle version installed, that is 11.2.0.3.0. Okay, so all the prerequisites are installed already in this system. That means these are all the prerequisites are mandate for any SAP system installation. It may be BW, it may be ECC or SEM, SRM, any SAP system can be installed after completion of all these tasks. Okay, the basic prerequisites are done. Now I am going to start the SAP BW installation. Okay, to start it, we should have the dump, that is installation files. I have copied the dump inside the C drive, that is with the name of dump folder. Here I have the installation master directory and the Oracle client and exports folder. So these are all the required installation files to install SAP BW. Let me start the installation using installation master, that is IM folder. Double click on it and double click on this number, and from here the data units, and then the folder related to this OS, that is NW731_IM Windows_x86-64 Ora. Double click on it, and then there is a file called SAP inst, that is exe file. Double click on it to start the installation master. I am minimizing the screen. Okay, it came to front. So this is the first screen to install SAP BW. SAP BW can be installed from SAP systems and the application server ABAP, and then standard system. Okay, and click on next button. SAP NetWeaver 7.3 means SAP BW will be installed as component within the system. SAP NetWeaver is a base for any SAP software. So SAP NetWeaver, if you are installing, SAP BW is a component within the NetWeaver system. Okay, you are installing SAP NetWeaver means you can think that you are installing SAP BW. Just click on next button here. And first time it will ask you to log off the system. Just click on the OK and provide the username and password to log in again. Control Alt Insert. Okay, it's not taking. VMware, just click on VM, just send Control Alt Delete. Enter the password. The installation should start automatically. Okay, SAP system ID how to provide? Just I am providing DEV as the system ID, that is development system. Click on the next button. And here I have to provide the master password. Click on the next button. And again the database DBS ID also we have to provide, that is within the Oracle software this particular database, that means this is the database SID, DBS ID. With this DBS ID, database will be created inside Oracle software. Oracle software we have already installed, but the SAP system will create database for its purpose, and click next here. Database host is BWinst. That means it is the same system where we are installing SAP software, that is BW software. So that itself is also a database server. And here you have to select the export folder. This software also, this installation export also we have in our C drive. Just click on the browse button, select C drive, and click on the dump button, and double click on exports. So we have to double click on this and select that entire folder. Okay, if you want to see the full path, okay, this is the full path of that folder, that is C:\dump/export/5104322 8. Just click on next. And this is the screen for Oracle database. It is giving you the summary of Oracle database. The database instance is installed in this home, that is DB home. Where exactly it is going? C:\oracle/oracle/dev/11203 is the Oracle home, that is DB home, database home. And the database server version is 11.2.0.3.0, that is 112 it is showing. If you have other version, it should be available as drop down here. If you have installed Oracle 10G, it will be available as drop down. But in this server, I have installed only Oracle 11.2. That's why it is only the version available. And the instance RAM is 4095, that is 4GB RAM it took for this particular instance. Total RAM available in this system is 8GB. And the database schema, the new default for ABAP schema is SAP SR3. So each database will have its own schema, that is ABAP schema is SAP SR3. The default name is SAP SR3, just you remember this name. And then click next. It is just only summary of the Oracle database. You have to accept all the defaults and the password also. Whatever the password you given for master password, that is while starting installation, same password will be applicable here. And this is the database directories and how much space it is going to utilize, everything it will show. So like this, here required disk space is 1540 and 12,694, that is 12 GB and 9 GB and 22 KB. This is total free space available is this much. And all the files are going to create within the C drive, because we have only C drive. Everything will goes into C drive. Okay, once check all these details, you can click on the next button in the screen. And you have to select the Oracle client. This particular software will communicate with the Oracle server. So this particular file also available in the C drive, that is in the dump folder. And this is the Oracle client software. Select it and click OK. So once it is done, just click next. and this is the diagnostics agent. Each system will create this particular instance. Just accept the default and click next. And it is going to create some users related to this diagnostics agent, that is SAP service DAA. So just click on the S button to create those users. And select no SLD destination in this screen. Click next. So this is the final parameter screen. Here you can click on the next to proceed with the installation. Okay, if you want to change any parameter or settings while whatever the selections you have done, you can click on that particular option and you can click on the revise button to change it. Okay, I have selected everything right so that I can click on next. I'm going to click on next. Click next. So the installation should start. It will take some time, like 2 to 3 hours time, and it will finish the installation. Once the installation is over, we can log on to the SAP BW system, and then we can create a new client, and then we can add SAP BI content into it. Okay, so here I am pausing the video. Let me come back with the finishing of the installation. Once the installation is finished, I will continue the video.
Welcome back. So the installation is completed. SAP Network 7.3, including enhancement package 1, SAP Systems Application Server App, Standard System has completed. So once you get this message, just click on the OK. So with this step, the SAP BW is completely installed. Now we have to install SAP GUI software to log on to the SAP BW. Let us install SAP GUI software in this system. So there is no GUI available here. Just let me copy from my network source. So once this is copied, just double click on GUI folder and double click on Windows Win32 SAP GUI setup. So SAP Network front end installer will be started. That means it is a front end software. With this we can log on to SAP BW system. Click on the next button and click on select all. Click next. Click next. click next. Click on the close. And this is the icon which you will get after completion of SAP GUI installation. Double click on it. It is blank, that is no entries are available in this window. Just right click here and click on the add new entry and click next. For description, SAP BW 7.3, and the application server is, application server can be find from here. Just double click on the SAP management console from the desktop, so this window will be open, and this is the application server name, that is BW inst. Or you can also find the application server using the run command, host name, so the same name will come here, BW inst, and just enter that BW inst here, and the instance number is also from here you can find out, that is 00 is the instance number, or you can find the instance number from the computer, that is after completion of BW installation you will get this user folder, and the user folder SAP folder will be there. Under that there is a dev with the SID which we have used for installation. The folder will be created with that name. Double click on dev, and this is the DVEBMDS00, that is these are all the processes, and 00 is the instance number. Okay, so that you have to provide that instance number here. Just 00, and system ID is dev. System ID also can be find from the screen, that is dev, and router string is not required, just leave that blank and click on the finish, so that entry will be created. You can log on to the SAP BW system using this entry, just you have to double click on it. So these, before logging onto the system, this system should be started. That means you should see all green color here, and if you see ASWP table, and it will ask you to enter the password, that is Windows administrator password you have to provide, and here you should have the status column all wait, and start column should be yes, and here different dialog work processes and background work processes and update spool, and the work processes are started and ready for taking requests from the users. Okay, so this should be started and ready, it should be ready, and you can minimize this screen, and you can double click on this entry to log on to the SAP BW system. And but by default the client shows here is 001 client, it is called support client, and the passwords which we have set while installation, that is master password, same password will be utilized, and the default users will be created in the SAP BW system are SAP star and DDIC. So I can use SAP star here, SAP star, and the password which I have given while installation of SAP BW. And here you can click continue, and by default the SAP systems will work for 3 months time, from now to February 2014 it will work. So you can use the BW system for 3 months practice. Okay, you can check the installation whether it is installed properly or not using SICK T code, SICK and hit enter, so that it will give you the information about your installation, that is no errors reported. Okay, and first step you need to do is you have to configure TMS. Just to configure TMS, you have to do the TMS configuration only in 000 client, so not in 001 client. If I try to configure TMS from here, so it should give me the information about TMS must be configured in client 000, so that I should log on to 000 client. Same entry can be used for logging into 000 client, and 000 here I can use either SCP star or DDIC. So these two users are default users, so any user can be used for logging in, and license expires on same date. Okay, within the SCP system you have these two clients. These are default clients, and one more client also will be there, 066, that is for support people use to connect to a customer system. Okay, so now let me configure TMS, that is using STMS T code. Hit enter, and in the first system you will get this screen, that is if you don't have TMS already configured in the system, you will get this box. Just you have to click on the save button. There is no need to change anything. Okay, and it will ask you to enter the password. Just provide the same password which you have used for installation. Okay, it is showing that no default company address has been maintained in the system. Create an address. So each SAP client should have the company name, company address, etc. ABC LTD Limited, and click on the continue button. Select the company, and country is India, and click on the copy button. Okay, I am making it as big screen. See, you are logged on to the domain controller. If I click over you and click on the systems, it should show the systems which are available in this TMS configuration. Right now we have only one system, that is dev system. It should show that information here. Okay, this is the development system. Only one system is available. Status is active and the configuration is up to date, and the release is 731. System dev, short text is system dev, and the system name is, that is system identifier is DEV, and it is a domain controller. This is the symbol of the domain controller. The first system will become domain controller. Okay, this is brief explanation about TMS configuration. Just now we have to almost all completed. We have to create a new client for the BW system. Just to create a new client, just log off from here and log on to 001 client, and log in as SAP star and password. Here let us see how many clients are available in the system. Okay, there are three clients available. I am going to create new client here. Just click on the to create new client, click on display or change, and this is a cross client. That means this table belongs to all the clients. That's why you should be very careful while changing this client, this table. So this is the information box. Just click on continue here. Okay, click on new entries to create new client, and the new client Can be anything like from 0, what is it called, 000 to 999, but except 066 and 001 and 000. So because all those three clients are already available in the system. Okay, let me give 100 here, yeah, and I will name this client as BW client, and the city I'm putting it as Hyderabad, and logical system is not yet created, so that I am not going to assign right now, or I can open another session to create logical system. So the to create logical system cell is the T code. Okay, from here you can click on the basic settings and click on logical systems, define logical system table. Again, it is cross client. This table also belongs to all the clients, so this is the information box. So no changes for user SAP star allowed. Choose display object or cancel. Okay, SAP star cannot create logical systems. Just to create logical system you have to log in as other user. Okay, just I can open this and I can log in as other user into the same client. DDI, see another user available, and using this I will try to create a logical system. The cell is the T code. Go to basic settings and logical systems, define logical system. Again, this is cross client, it is showing. Okay, data is locked by user SAP star and can be displayed. Okay, this screen we have to exit from here, because with using SAP star we have already tried to create logical system, that's why it is showing here. Yes, no entries exist. Go back again and click on that define logical system. No, it should not give that. Okay, even DDIC also not able to create logical system. So to create logical system we should have some other user. Okay, so let me create a user now. SU01 is the T code for creating users, and I'm putting SAP user as a first user which I am going to create in this system. And again, 001 client also doesn't have any company information, that's why it is showing here. Same company I am creating here also, and select the company and IMDIA, click copy. So we have seen logging into different types of clients, that is 000 and 001 with different users, that is SAP star and DDIC. These are all default clients and default users. Now whatever we are creating is extra user, that is that belongs to us, that is you can create your own user here. Yeah? And if I right click here, it will not paste it. There is an option called quick cut and paste. If you select it, if you can select and just right click here, that name will be appear here. Click on the logon data and the information, that is initial password, initial I'm putting, and go to profiles. I am giving full authorization to this particular user because this is the user will do most of the work, that is SAP underscore all is one profile and SAP underscore new is one profile. Click on the save button. Password. Click on save. Yes, user SAP user created. Just log off from here. Okay, now we can log on to system using SAP user into the same client. SAP user and password is and it should be changed at first logon. Okay, I have changed it and it is showing one failed password attempt. Okay, let it be. So now SAP user has been created. Now we can use SALT code for creating logical systems. Now we should not get that error and define logical systems. Click on continue. So no entry exists. Click on new systems. That is logical system is now our SID of the BW system is dev and CLNT client, and the new client name is 100. Okay, this can be anything, but for easy remembrance I'm using SID and the client number which we are going to use it as BW client. So the dev CLNT 100 and BW client we can name it as. Okay, once it is done, click on the save button here. So okay, it will ask you to create the transport request. Just click on the create new transport request. You can name this particular task as BW logical system. That is 00100, or you can put something complete information, that is dev CLNT 100. Okay, click on the save button here. Whatever the changes you do within the system, that will be recorded as client requests, that is transport requests. Okay, so that can be transported to other systems if you have configured TMS with quality and production, so that you can transfer these changes to other systems also. Okay, there is no need to do these tasks again and again. Okay, within three system landscape, that means development system if you are doing that can be transferred to quality system, then to production. Okay, for that purpose you have to record all changes within the system using this request numbers, that is request transport request. It is called workbench request. Okay, click on the continue button. So logical system has been created. Now our 100 client has been given with this number. Okay, so that you can select the initial screen where we are going to create the new client in the system. So from here you can select this button, that is possible options button. It is called as possible options button, or you can use F4 also from your keyboard. Click on this button to get the list of all logical systems created in the system. So this is the logical system. Double click here, and standard currency you can put as INR, and client role you can click training or education. Okay, and click on save button. Yeah, accept all the defaults here. Okay. It is the information box. Be careful when changing the logical system. See long text. That means it is allocated with this logical system, so that you should not change logical systems from the SALT code. Okay, just you should be very careful. Just click continue. Once it is assigned, means it is treated as logical system in the SAP system. Okay, logical system has been, so the client is created, and now we can try to log out to the system using a new client, newly created client, and the newly created client can be logged in as SAP star, but the password is pass, PASS pass. That is the default password. That is only the user available for logging into the new client, because you don't have any configuration or tables included in the new client, we have to do the client copy to have all the tables required for client operation. Okay, but SAP Star user by default is disabled in SAP systems. You have to enable that particular password. So to enable it, you have to change the parameters. Like for suppose if I want to show you how the error looks like, double click on SAP BW7.3 entry, and newly created client is 100, okay, and the username is SAP Star, and if I use the pass, PASS pass, and hit enter, so it should give me the error. That means it is not going to log on because SAP Star password is disabled in the system. So to enable the SAP Star password, so within the same system, we have already logged as SAP Star and 001 client. From here we can use RZ10T code for changing the parameters of system, and here you can select the profiles, but because it is newly created system, that's why no profiles are available here. You can import from the utilities, import profiles, click on off active service. Okay, profiles are imported. Just click on this possible options button and select the default profile, and select extended maintenance, click on the change button, and from here you can search for the parameter. Like you can create the new parameter, and new parameter can be searched from F4. I am using F4 button F4 key from the keyboard to search for the new parameter. So it's not coming. F4, no. Click on this button and click on this arrow mark, and type SAP Star. SAP Star is the user, is the parameter value. So with this name, the parameter is there, that is login/no_automatic_user_SAP Star. Okay, so we have to select, double click on it, and it will give you this value, and that is 1. That means no automatic user SAP Star will be available for newly created clients. So we have to make, we have to change the parameter to 0 to make SAP Star password pass user will work in the newly created client. Okay, I hope you understood this, and go back and click on the copy button again. Go back here and click on the save button here, and it will show this screen. Just click on the no, it will show incorrect parameter values detected, display values. I don't want to see, just click on no. And do you want to activate the profile? Click on the S button. Okay, it will be activated. And now once you change any parameter, you should restart the instance, then only the changes will be come into effect. Okay, click continue here, and system log off. Yes, and even we can close all the screens as of now, whatever the screens we have logged in, and close this screen also, and even you can close these, and everything is closed. Okay, even this also can be closed, but it is not stopped. Okay, so once you double click again, it will come back. Okay, double click on here. Sorry, we have to stop the instance. No, so to stop the instance, we have to double click on SAP Management Console. So open it here and double right click on dev. It is already in started condition. Just right click here and click on the stop. So to stop the instance, and it will ask you to enter the password, that is Windows administrator password. And after some time, everything will be stopped. Just click on process list, back WP table. After some time, everything should be stopped. Wait should be down, and after some time, nothing will be available here. And the color also changes to gray color. Okay, now it is yellow, and even this is also stopping.
So everything is stopped. Okay, completely stopped. Now again right click and click on the start button to start everything. So click OK and ASWP table. Click refresh. First of all, process list. These processes will be started. So dispatcher and gateway. Okay. So if you click about table, you should get this information. So everything should come to wait, and here start is yes. You have to wait for some time. Yes, 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 it is starting. So everything is started. Okay, we can log on to the system. Okay, now once it is started, you can close the screen and double click on SAP BW 7.3, and now I can change the client number to 100. Okay, SAP star is the user name and password is pass. Hit enter. Now it is logging in. Okay, because we have changed that parameter to 0, that's why it is allowing me to log in. So newly created client, you will not have anything here. Like for example, if I use SU01 T code to create a new user account, that is with SAP user 1, hit enter, sorry, click on the create button, and no company default address, everything it is okay like this. And even after clicking here and after giving the company details, if you want to select that Mr. Mrs. and company, that information also will not be there because it is newly created client. Okay, for suppose if I select ABC Limited, and here you see, for suppose if you click here, nothing will be there, and here also nothing will be there because it is new client, nothing is there. So you have to pull all the details of defaults, that information from source client to destination client. Okay, so now what we have to do the local client copy, that is we have to copy from the source to destination. That means I will use 001 client as source and 100 is the destination. To perform local client copy, you have to log into destination client, and then you have to use SECL is the T code. Okay, SECL is for local client copy. To perform local client copy, you should log on to destination client, that means newly created client. Okay, and you just must remember that information. And selected profile, I want to copy complete profile, that is SAP all client specific data without change documents. Okay, SAP all, and the source client is 001, and source user master record, whatever the users available in the source, that those users also will come to newly created client, that is SAP user we have created in 001, that SAP user will be available in newly created client also. Okay, so you can click on the schedule as background job here. Okay, we can also test the client copy, but directly I am clicking on scheduling as background job, and schedule the job, and the scheduling job also immediately the job will be started. And that is background server, whatever the server is available right now is BW inst, that is host name, and dev is the instance SID, that is system identifier, and 00 is the instance number. Okay, with that the complete name looks like this, that is background server. So this is only the background server available as of now, so that you can select from here and click on the schedule job. And this is the summary screen, that is verification, whatever the selections we have made, that it will show, and click on the continue button to start the client copy. And background job was successfully scheduled, log is displayed in SEC3. Okay, so click continue here, and you can see the log information from SEC3 here. Okay, it will take some time to perform complete the client copy. Okay, we have to wait. So that I will pause the video here. Once I get this message, so then I'll come back with the successful message. So once it come back to successful, then I'll show you how to execute T code of BW system. Okay, this is the successfully completed message. Actually, the client 100 got stopped. That is due to some power failure. So I have created another new client with the number 200, and I repeated the same client copy, that is SCCL, using SCCL is local client copy. So it is successfully completed. Okay, now let us system and log off and log in once again using the newly created client. That is changed to 200 and the SAP user. SAP user is created in 001 because we have selected 001 as source client. Okay, the same user is available in 200 client also. So this is the client 200 client. From here you can execute the T code RSA1. Okay, so you can work only in 100 client, so that you have to do small setting to make this work. Okay, just first of all let us change the default client to 200 using RZ10 T code. Select the default profile and click on extended maintenance, click on the change button, and login/system client should be changed to 200, and click on the copy and go back, click on the copy, go back, and here you save, and click on no here and click on yes here. That's it. And now the profile will be activated only when you restart the instance. So let us restart the instance. Click log off here, and restarting the instance means stopping of instance and starting it again. Okay, it is completely stopped. Now we can start it again. Just right click and click on the start button. It will take some time and it will start. Okay, it is started. Now we can log on to the system. Double click on this entry. Now the default client is 200. Just look at here. And the same username. Okay, now we'll try to execute the T code RSA1. Okay, click S here. Do you want to start the documentation on navigating in the modeling view in a separate window? You can access this function from the main menu, data warehousing workbench, documentation and modeling. You can select it and do not show this question again, and click on the no button. There is no need to open the documentation. So this is a data warehousing modeling workbench. Okay, here BI content is there, and You can click on it so that you can work on your data warehousing workbench. So that's it. So I hope you understood. This video is very useful for you to install SAP BW. Okay, if any queries are there, please do comment. Thanks for watching this video.